Hello guys, so welcome back to another Day R Survival. I'm your host, Mobile Gaming. So we are at Tver. I'm gonna say Tver. We came all the way up here, and you can tell I've looted all along the road. I looted all these cities and houses, and now we are at the survivor's base. And let's continue on to our quest. It leads us here. So first, let's continue on. I can't believe it. After so many days on my own, after all my endless searching, a hair's breadth away from death, I made it. On the outskirts of Tver, I discovered signs of life in an intact apartment block. It was the light of a kerosene lamp in a window, and someone had hung laundry out to dry on a third floor balcony. When I spotted the two kids carrying buckets away from the river, I felt a lump formed in my throat. They are survivors. That means my family could be alive too. Alright, I asked the local about Svetlana. After spotting me, the boys ran and hid in the building entrance. A minute later, three men with guns came out. One of them shouted for me to drop my weapon and walk towards them with my hands up. I did it without hesitating. The men searched me thoroughly, and only then did they lower their guns. Next, I asked about Svetlana. After a quick glance around, they replied that Svetlana was on the third floor. I walked past them, feeling their weary eyes on me. In apartment 11, a thin, dark-haired woman of about 30 sat writing at a table. She was wearing an old white robe. Like the men, she looked haggard. "Hello!" The woman raised her sad gray eyes to mine and smiled warmly. "Hello? We haven't seen any new faces in a little while. So who are you? Where did you come from?"
"Who am I? I'm a drifter. I came from the north."
"Really?" The woman was astonished. "We thought there was no one left up there. Well, come in. Make yourself comfortable. I'm Svetlana, by the way."
"Svetlana from Leningrad, right? You're the person who invented the cure for the epidemic, who was captured by bandits, and who escaped and made it all the way here to Tver on foot?"
Svetlana frowned. "Yes, that's right. But how do you know all this?"
"I was looking for you. I found your recorder in Leningrad. I was also in Novgorod, at the bandits' base."
"Alright, but why were you looking for me?"
"I was looking for survivors. People who could tell me the truth about what happened. Back in 1984, you see? I don't remember anything. I've even forgotten my own name."
"You don't remember anything? What happened?"
"Well, that's what I'm telling you. I don't know. I woke up in Nikel. I didn't know who I was, where I was from, or how I got there. And there were just rotten corpses and ruins and all around me. I started searching for answers, for people who could explain it all. And you're the first person I've met who can do that."
"Alright." Svetlana looked at me with genuine sympathy. "That's awful. It's a miracle you even made it this far." She smiled kindly. "But that's all behind you now. We'll take care of you. We'll give you a room and feed you. And little by little, your memories will come back. I'm sure of it."
"Svetlana, I..."
"But you have to work for the good of the collective. Our commune is small. We live from hand to mouth. So we can use an extra body to help out."
"Svetlana, thank you. Thank you for the offer, but I can't stay here for you all."
Svetlana was silent. Then she stood and walked to the window. "Why not?"
"I have a wife and a daughter. I don't know where they are, but I'm convinced they're alive, waiting for me. I have to find them."
Svetlana turned away. "Look out the window. It's a wasteland. First the epidemic, then the nuclear war. The Earth died. You can't survive there. Radiation, predators, crazy people with nothing left to lose, bandits. You won't find anyone out there. But if you go, you won't be coming back. We won't try to hold you here. But just think for a second."
"You're right, but I have to try. I can't abandon my family. And after that, Well, there's probably are other settlements. The whole Union can't have died off. Maybe there are survivals in the south, beyond the Urals. Maybe there are. We don't know. No one has ever come from there. We're not leaving the Tver outskirts. We barely have enough food. But there are few predators here. And who said that things were better in other parts? You need to think straight and stay.
Svetlana, everything you're saying is true. But if you were in my place, wouldn't you still go and look for your family? No matter how dangerous it was?
Svetlana looked mournfully at me. You know, when I got here, I tried to find relatives too, and other survivors. I searched for a way to get in touch with my colleagues, to find out more about this damn epidemic, about the bombing. I traveled from town to town until I ran out of gas, but it was all for nothing. All my efforts went up in smoke.
I'm sorry about that, and I know that I've only got a slim chance, but it is a chance. I'm going to search. If I have to, I'll go beyond the Urals to other countries.
Svetlana stared into my eyes for a long time, and then shifted her gaze. I fought as long as I could too. I believe that we could still do something, still right what had gone wrong.
But aren't you doing something? You're wearing a doctor's coat. You treat people. You haven't given up.
And didn't you give up when the bandits took you prisoner?
No, you poisoned them. And even though you'd risk your own life to do it.
Svetlana gripped her head with her hands. You don't understand.
I probably don't. Anyway, it was good to meet you, Svetlana. I hope to see you again someday.
Leave. Wow. I think Svetlana just probably just gave up on life, you know? I mean, she saw so many horrible things that I think she just wants to settle down and just live her life in Tver. The survivor found refuge in the gray 5-story building on the riverbank. 2 dozen people live here. Without heating or running water, they grow potatoes, cabbages, and carrots in the small patches around the building, and the wasteland starts just beyond the rotten wooden fence.
How about, let's go to the infirmary.
The door to Svetlana's room is shut, but it sounds like she's in. I could knock, but I think she just wants to be alone for a while.
Alright. Look around and talk to the locals.
The Tver settlement is a miserable enough place, but none of the inhabitants complained. They were warm and friendly, and happily answered my questions. I learned that the base leader is somebody called Evgenie, an agriculturist, and that a doctor called Svetlana looks after the inhabitants' health.
Go to the infirmary. No? Leave. Alright.
Ooh. Hello. Hello, traveler. Would you like to have a rest?
Yes?
When I woke up, Svetlana was standing next to me. She was looking at me intently, nervously chewing her lips.
Have you changed your mind? Any chance you'll stay?
Oh, she really wants me to stay and settle down with her, maybe. No, I have to get going.
Svetlana nodded slowly. My answer didn't surprise her, but why was she so anxious? I feel sorry for you, Drifter. People like you are the first to die. People who love, who take risks to save others. I thought all the other people like you died out back in 84. That the only ones left were bandits and people like me. The ones who stopped caring altogether.
Yeah, she did give up on life, caring for people. Sorry, Svetlana, but you don't look like somebody who stopped caring. You're trying to save me, after all.
Svetlana smiled strangely. What of it? I'm not risking anything.
Fine. Damn you. If you want to leave, leave. But if you're going anyway...
She paused to think, choosing her words.
Yeah, I'm listening.
Svetlana lowered her voice as though she's afraid of being overheard. There's one thing you can do. I started it a long time ago, but I never finished it. I give it halfway.
Svetlana makes a wry face.
But you could do it.
Okay, what's the thing?
I need to uncover the truth about the catastrophe.
I don't get it. What else is there to uncover? You know everything. The epidemic broke out, then there was a nuclear war.
You read my diary, didn't you? On one of the pages I lost, I wrote down a strange idea.
I still don't know how I didn't think of it sooner, but this idea keeps me awake at night.
I don't know.
Svetlana speaks more quietly. The epidemic broke out at the same time in different cities, at opposite ends of the USSR. No virus in history has ever spread like that. A disease can always be localized. You can set up quarantines, take preventative measures. At least you can try, but not with this disease. I checked it. The virus attacked everyone everywhere simultaneously. There was no way of stopping it. It sounds crazy, but could someone have deliberately started the epidemic and infecting people in different cities at the same time?
Svetlana, this is crazy. Who would want to do that, and what would they get out of it?
I don't know. I've been trying to figure that out since I was held prisoners by the bandits. I tried to find a rational explanation. Then here, outside Tver, I asked the other refugees. I looked through newspapers, stories of the disease.
Svetlana, even if you're right, if the epidemic is a man-made, even if it's some kind of conspiracy, how can you ever get to the truth? So many years have passed. It's madness.
Svetlana jumps up and looks at me with a strange fury in her eyes.
I know that, but it is no more madness than going out into the wasteland to search for your family.
Svetlana calms down and lowers her voice again. Then again, we do still know something. The first lethal outbreaks were dated to September 2nd and 3rd. Taking the incubation period into account, I think those people were infected around August 17th and 19th. That means...
August 17th? Hang on, I've seen that date somewhere before.
Show Svetlana the telegram of the dead man in Novgorod. Activate DAR on August 17th as instructed.
What's this? Where did you get this?
Oh, maybe the epidemic was spread by that spray. Maybe it's airborne?
In Novgorod, from a body. But there's more. I have a spray can somewhere that I found in Petrozavodsk. It marked DAR too. Do you know what it means?
No, I don't. But I think I've heard the name before from my father. When he visited the institute, he spoke to someone on the phone and mentioned this DAR. I asked him what it meant, but he just brushed it off with a joke. But I made it a point to remember it.
Interesting. Who's your father?
He was a microbiologist, one of the best in the country. He worked in Moscow at the Institute of Virology. That was the last time I saw him. He died of a heart attack in June of 1984. But my mother told me over the phone. I didn't even get the chance to say goodbye. I didn't even go to the funeral. I was on bed rest with tonsillitis.
At the Institute of Virology, you say? In Moscow? Since this is my only lead, it looks like I'm going to Moscow.
Svetlana held her breath.
So you agree to help me?
Okay, I'll try, but I won't promise anything. My main priority is to find my wife and daughter. No, hold on. Resting, I haven't decided anything yet. At the end of the day, my priority is to find my wife.
How about the first one?
I understand, but you have to understand me. I don't have any close relative left. And no one needs a cure for the disease anymore. What do I have left? Survival? My goal in life is to live just a little bit longer. But I'm already sick of this existence. But we can do one thing. Find the truth. Find out who is responsible for killing millions of people and for turning our country, maybe in the world, into a wasteland. And find out why they did it. This is important, isn't it? Not just for me, but for all of us. I know you don't have to do it. All I can do is ask and offer a reward.
A reward? It's gotta be a big reward. Alright, I see what I can do.
I'll go and get ready to go to head out. Will you wait a little longer?
Svetlana, this is a bad idea. The wasteland is too dangerous for somebody who isn't prepared. I can't protect you, and you'll be leaving the people here without a doctor. It's better if you stay.
Are you sure?
I'm sure.
Okay, alright. Can we go back to her? No, okay. Let's finish. See you later. Let's leave. So we got to go to Moscow. Okay. But before that, let's...
Let's investigate the city first. So I am at 100% health and everything is good. Let's investigate Tver. Let's see if we can get anything useful after all this dialogue. Let's go in here. The post office. Okay. Get this package. This table. Alright. Let's go in here. The library. What is that book? I think it's chemistry, is it? Or survival. I think it's survival. Yeah, it is survival. Yeah, that's... Alt T, nice. Alright, let's get our health down. I mean, not our health, our radiation poisoning. First of all, okay, let's fix that. Can we break this down and then make a fire? Now let's drink some tea. I don't have a pot. Oh my god. All right, let's drink this vodka. All right, before that, no. There's no oil in that. Ugh, I just made the wrong one. There we go. We got a dead body. We can actually pick up all that up and then go back because we have a pot now. Make the tea. Drink the tea. Nice. Okay, I think we're good now. Oh, let's watch some television. Watching this television gives me something for free. Let's pick that up. Alright, let me be back when we watch this TV. Okay, alright, we're back. Let's see what kind of reward we get. Come on, something nice. Coins, yo, 25, that's it. Ugh, whatever. 25, that's a little for watching the whole entire show. Okay. Let's go in here. The garage. Nice. Maybe I can make my, maybe I can make my car now. Hopefully. Can I get this motorcycle parts? Why not? I can't. Okay, let's drink some more vodka. I'm dying of radiation poisoning. Okay. Let's go to this university, is it? The pharmacy, hospital. Okay, I need to take this. But before that, let's just search the city. Nice. I got a chemistry set. Let's drink some more vodka before I start dying. I am getting sleepy when I drink vodka. That is one of the downfalls of drinking alcohol. I think they're giving me a lot of this chlorocysteamine is because I'm going to Moscow. I'm probably gonna have a lot of radiation poisoning. And so, this will prevent me from having that. So, I need to store up on that and get ready for Moscow. Okay, I'm getting hungry now. Alright, let's... Wait a minute, I don't have my bow, but that's okay. I think they're not that deadly, right? One more hit. Good. Let's just end our turn. Let's go here, in our turn. Alright. One, two, and we're good. Okay, luckily I brought an axe. Whew, or else I would have been in trouble. Okay, we got some rat meat. Is impossible to search in darkness? Can I load up? Okay, great. Lucky. Oh, I'm sleeping. Can I not sleep? Thank you. Let me use this. Can I... let's eat this. Perfect. Radiation 17, it's bearable. Let's keep searching. Let's get all this. X. And anywhere that I can. How about this car place? Perfect. Drain the fuel. Pick this up. And then carry it and go to my base. And we're good. We are great. Can I disassemble? Maybe just one more and then I'll go back to my base. Get everything set up. And get ready to go to Moscow after I loot everything. Okay, I am getting overloaded. How about just drop this car parts? Getting too heavy. No, I think it's because of the wheels. Okay, two. There we go. Perfect. Alright, let's go back to our base. Five, four, let's actually go in here. Let's build a fire. No. Well, we need to break down our table first. Kindle fire. And let's go to sleep. Okay, so I need to eat something, get my health back up, my radiation going down, go back to Tver and search the city, and prepare for Moscow. Alright. I'm almost done. Perfect. Let's save. Actually, you know what? I think I need to build this so that I can make a fire. Scraps, wires, flint. Okay. I can't do it now. But let's go in here. Let's cook something. Fire. Can I make this? Scraps and flint. Okay. We'll do that later. Drink some water. Make some tailed risoli. I got three of them. Okay, let's see. Perfect. Now, let's drop all of this. So, let's drop that. I only need one for now. And oh, let's open this package. Red wine, I like that. And read this book. Search the dead bodies. Okay. Let's disassemble this to get the experience points for mechanics. Maybe I should bury them. Get some experience point, yeah, I'll just bury them. And let's see. What else can I drop? Drop that. Drop all of this. Why did I bring all this with me? Oh, I must have picked it up from the dead bodies. Okay. What can I bring? Let's repair this. Just in case. Okay. Let's sleep. Get to 100. And then, alright, and call it a video. Well, thanks for guys for watching. Like and subscribe my video if you enjoy it. And I'll see you when I am at... when I am at Moscow. It looks like it's a big city. So I'm gonna go all the way down here, loot a few cities, make my base maybe here actually, maybe around here. Yeah, maybe there. And hopefully by then, I'll get a car. So, I'll see you guys next time.